Major General Romero Bronner Jr., named as the new commanding general of the Philippine Army. He replaces Lieutenant General Andres Centino, who was appointed head of the armed forces in November. Bronner served as deputy commander of the military task force that fought against the pro-list Islamic State gunmen who attacked Marawi City in 2017. He was appointed as commander of the 4th Infantry Division in July. The new Philippine Army chief belongs to the Philippine Military Academy Makatao class of 1989.
Justices of the Philippine Supreme Court vote on the constitutionality of the country's Anti-Terrorism Act. This comes several months after they wrapped up debates on the contentious measure. But the results of the voting have yet to be released. The High Court spokesman says the votes still need to be tallied. Meanwhile, Associate Justice Marvick Leonin called out a local radio station for jumping the gun about the outcome of the vote. The radio station reported that the anti-terror law was deemed constitutional by the SC. But Justice Leonin said this was wrong. He says the public should wait for the court's formal announcement. Another petition filed with the Philippine Election Commission seeking to block the presidential bid of former Senator Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The new petitioners include martial law victims from the Ilocos region, the bailiwick of the Marcoses. They insist an appellate court ruling which affirmed Marcos's failed to file to his income tax returns in 1995 is reason enough to perpetually disqualify him from seeking public office. The petitioner's lead counsel is former election commissioner and constitutionalist attorney Christian Munsot. This is the 8th legal challenge to oppose Marcos's presidential bid.
Philippine Vice President Lenny Robredo again shuns political dynasty, saying it will never happen in their family. Speaking to her supporters in Baguio City, Robredo reveals politicians have been urging her eldest daughter, Aika, to run for public office.
Alam mo si Aika, dalawang eleksyon na nililigawan ng ibang mga politiko sa amin, kinukumbinse to run for mayor or to run for another position. Ang policy namin, hanggang nakaupo pa ako sa gobyerno, walang ibang pwedeng kumandidato sa atin.
The presidential aspirant adds she did not replace her late husband, the late Jesse Robredo, when his term ended as mayor of the Philippine city of Naga. Contact and non-contact sports back in Davao City. The city's COVID task force issued a resolution allowing games such as basketball, volleyball, and football, but with certain restrictions. Only fully vaccinated persons will be allowed to play, and the games can only be held in courts managed by local villages. This means street ball or playing in makeshift courts is still prohibited. Tournaments and leagues also are not yet allowed, as playing is limited to exercise purpose only. Spectators will be permitted for 70% maximum venue capacity. Health protocols should also be strictly observed.
The Philippines are looking to allow more health workers to work abroad before the end of the year. Labor Secretary Silvestre Bello III says 500 more medical workers could soon be deployed overseas. That's even if the government's annual cap of 6,500 has already been met.
Sa dami nang humingi, yung technical working group nag-promise sila na for the last portion of this year, pwede tayong bumigay ng mga 500 pa. Kasama dyan yung special request ng Brunei. Humingi sila sa akin ng 200. Bait na mabait sa ating bansang Brunei. Kaya at saka maganda ang pa-trato nila sa ating mga OFW. Kaya kumpiyansa kami na pagbigyan yung bansang Brunei.
The annual cap of nurses and other healthcare workers being deployed abroad was set to ensure the Philippines will have enough health workers amid the pandemic.